Hey guys, this is Ulrich from Nostalgic Mathematics. Welcome to our MID Integration B 2022 series. Today we turn attention to the problem 3 of the second semifinal. We will compute this integral. If you are new here, do not forget to subscribe. So we want to compute I. Honestly, I gotta say that I found this integral very frustrating and hard. Because actually, the theorem I use to solve this is not the first thing you think about when you have an integral. First, you just try to have a good substitution, to do integration by parts, or even turn it into a differential equation. But here, none of these work. So it was really frustrating for me. You'll see in a while why. Well, so to begin with, let's focus on the denominator. Rewrite as follows. We know that cotangent of x is cosine x over sine x, and we rewrite cosecant of x by its definition. So once you have a square here, so we are looking for cos square over sine square, but we get it here because 1 is cosine square plus sine square. We group, and then we have our square, and we know that this to be cotangent of x, and we have this. So ax is ux squared plus 1, with ux defined as x minus cotangent of x. So one of the ideas you may want to try is to have this form, because if you have this form, you know that you're going to use arctangent of u. But the problem is that the derivative of u is 1 plus 1 over sine squared. But this term, we don't know how to handle it. So this won't work. Now, what can we do? But we can still rewrite I simply. So I rewrite as follow. With this function fx, 1 over 1 plus x squared. And we know how to compute this integral. The integral from minus infinity to infinity of fx dx is very simple. So actually, you're going to take arctangent of x between the infinity and negative infinity, which is pi. So it seems like we are stuck, but here we have a theorem that allows us to link this integral to the integral of that form with a range of very selected nonlinear functions. It's true that the cotangent function is not among these functions, but we can still manage to use this theorem. Actually, we want to apply Glaser's master theorem. It is stated as follows. So this integral is equal to that integral when ai is a positive real and bi is just a real. So we have these constraints on the coefficients, but the issue here is that cotangent of x doesn't have this form. That's where sometimes you need to be genius or you need to have some mathematical culture. So we know that we have another result that allows us to link the cotangent function with these functions. So cotangent of x is the limit of this expression. So we see that this expression has this form. So we can apply Glaser's theorem with this form. So we know that this integral is going to be this one, because actually ai is always one here, which is positive, so we can apply Glaser's theorem. Next, we apply the limit when n tends to the infinity. Because this limit exists, we can switch the integral and the limits. So we push the limits under the integral to have this. But given this result, we know that this limit is going to be f of x minus cotangent of x. That's it. And we know that I equals this quantity, so I is this integral, and therefore I equals pi, and this is our answer. Thank you for your attention. Again, do not forget to subscribe, like, share, and post your comments. Bye.